So far, I've talked a lot about the principles of Mach-based architectures, and I've talked a lot about headless systems. What I haven't talked about is how to implement applications using headless platforms and using Mach-based architectures. In this video, I'm going to be talking about one of those implementation patterns. I'm going to be talking about backend for a frontend, or BFF. Yes, you got it, a BFF. It's not a best friend forever for a developer, but what is a BFF? Let's find out and let's get to it. If you're building a front-end application from microservices with more than one headless system, there is a simple pattern you can adopt, and that's the direct point-to-point approach. In other words, you just call the API you need when you need it from within the application. And this approach is fine for simple applications, but there are downsides when it comes to more complicated applications. One of the first issues you might encounter is that the front end has to understand a lot more about the back end and its APIs. For instance, to add or update a microservice API will cause code changes in your front end application. It can also make it difficult to swap out different vendor APIs. Ultimately, this means you need new versions of the application that need to be deployed. Another complication is that the data coming back from the microservices may not be formatted or filtered or constructed in the way that the front-end application needs. Let's consider the scenario of viewing a basket. You'll first make a call to the basket API, which may return a set of IDs. You'll then call the product API for each of the IDs and get returned a whole set of product information, when all you really need is a list of products with their ID, their name, their price, and maybe a thumbnail image. And this means that every application front-end needs to have additional code and additional logic to translate the data from the microservice into the right format for the UI. What this example demonstrates is that you also need to orchestrate many API calls before you get the final data format. And if this is not abstracted away from the presentation, it means that the front ends will become more and more complicated and more difficult to maintain. And what can compound this further is that each front end application can have different requirements and require different logic. For instance, a voice application has a completely different experience and set of requirements than an e-commerce web application. Or an app used for an in-store customer assistant will be very different to apps used for servicing customers themselves. And finally, from a technical perspective, the huge number of calls that you make in a point-to-point application may hurt performance, particularly in browser applications. If you like this video so far, can you do me one favor? Can you scroll down a little bit and press that like button? Thank you. Okay, what is a backend for a frontend and how does it help? Well, simply put, it is a custom API that sits between the backend microservices APIs and the front-end application. Instead of the front-end application being responsible for calling all the microservices and processing the results, it makes a single call to the BFF. So it calls its own custom backend API, which in turn calls the relevant microservices. It would then structure and format the responses from those microservices, and then finally deliver the response nicely formatted back to the front-end. And as a result, it will reduce the complexity in the front-end. A BFF acts as a simple interface between the front end and the microservices. A BFF is focused on a single UI and only that UI. And as a result, it will help to keep front ends more simple and lighter. And front end requirements will be separated from the back end concerns, making it much easier to maintain. And the application will know less about your API structure, meaning it is much more resilient to API changes. Another interesting point is that server errors are meaningless to a front end, but a BFF can take those server errors and transform them into something that means something to a user and thereby improve the user experience. BFFs can also hide the sensitive information that might be returned in microservices calls and also omit data that's not required. This gives it an extra added layer of security. Another great benefit of this pattern is that application development can be separated into different teams far more easily. The front-end development teams would be responsible for the BFF, meaning they have much more control over how they consume the APIs and taking out any dependencies from the API development. You may think by having a BFF, you've increased the number of network steps and therefore increased the latency, so decreased the performance of the application. But building BFFs means you can intelligently build batch calls to the microservice APIs and also return a more concise set of formatted data to the user experience. When building headless application architectures using a BFF, there are many things to consider and avoid. You must avoid building self-contained, inclusive APIs in the BFF. All of your self-contained APIs should be in the API layer. The API is only a translation layer. It is not creating a new API. You also need to make sure that you avoid duplication. A BFF is for an application. It is not for a type of device. For example, the user experience in a native application, whether it's iOS or Android, will pretty much be the same. And in these cases, you should only have one BFF for that application, not for the Android version and the iOS version, because the logic will pretty much be the same. Another thing you should try to avoid is relying too heavily on the BFF. All of your features and your security should be held within either the front end or your APIs. The BFF is just to fill a gap. It's not there to add new features or new services to your application. The BFF can be a really useful pattern for implementing platforms using Mac architectures and headless architectures, but it's not the only one. In later videos, I'll look at other patterns like GraphQL and API gateways. But for now, I'd highly recommend watching my videos on the Mac concepts if you haven't done so already. And you should start with microservices because it will help you clarify this pattern even further. And it will help you understand how they fit into Mac-based architectures. And before you go, don't forget to subscribe. But for now, I'd like to say thank you, goodbye, and I'll see you next time.